Hi students, welcome back. In the previous sessions, we were discussing the digestion of the food. How the digestion of food occurs, we were discussing. The main part of digestion is small intestine. Here, the food is mainly not only digested, but also absorbed. So, small intestine is the main organ of digestion as well as the absorption. Small intestine, here is a lumen or cavity of small intestine. This is a lumen. Here is a serosa. I'm not trying anything. Muscularis externa, submucosa, and this is the mucosal layer, for example. This is the mucosal layer. Mucosa. Here consists of epithelial cells. Here called as a columnar epithelial cells. Okay. And when the food is digested, this mucosa is drawn into the folds. This mucosa is drawn into the folds here. And these are called as villi. The finger-shaped structures called as villi are present. For example, here is the villus. The villus is drawn here, is lined by the columnar epithelial cells. Columnar epithelial cells. The plasma membrane of these columnar epithelial cells are having the microvilli. This gives the brush border surface. So, villi add along with the microvilli increases the surface area of absorption of the digested food. So, the digested food particles like glucose are now moving to the various mucosal layers here moving. That is, the digested food particles like glucose, fructose, galactose, amino acids, etc. are moving through the mucosal epithelium, here mucosal layer, and they must be absorbed into the blood. From the blood, these absorbed food particles must be transported to the cells here and tissues, because here there have to be catabolism, oxidation of the foodstuffs. For example, oxidation of the glucose molecule in order to release the energy in the form of ATP, catabolism takes place inside the cells. That's why these particles like glucose and other food particles need to be transported to the cells here. Now, how this transport occurs, how this absorption occurs, that absorption of the digested food particles occurs to the special transport mechanism. What is that special transport mechanism? How this is done? Let's discuss now. Clear? So, transport of is of basically two types. One is the active transport. Okay, watch out. Next one is passive transport. Active transport and passive transport. There is a basic difference is present here. Active transport always utilizes energy in the form of ATP. ATP is a metabolic energy, because it's a metabolic, it's a result of metabolism here, catabolism. That's why metabolic energy in the form of ATP is utilized by the during the transport of the food particles, which are going to the active transport. They utilize the energy in the form of ATP. But when the food particles do not utilize ATP, when the digested food particles do not utilize the ATP during the transport, that is called as the passive transport. That is the first difference. Next one is active transport moves from the region of lower concentration to the higher concentration. Lower concentration to the higher concentration by utilizing the energy in the form of ATP. That is called as active transport. Now, second difference here. Here, for the region of higher to the lower concentration, because it do not utilize the ATP during the transport of these food particles, which do not utilize the energy, and they move from the region of higher to the lower concentration, such a transport of food particles is called as a passive transport. This active transport is of basically two different types. Active transport is of mainly two types. One is the primary active transport. And next one is a secondary active transport. There is a basic difference. Both of them utilize energy. But the primary active transport, the food particles utilizes the energy in the form of ATP. What is primary active transport? The food particles utilizes the energy during the transport mechanism. That is called as primary active transport. The food particle. Next one is, when the food particles do not utilize ATP, but some other energy. For example, some other energy means here, you take this is a membrane, cell membrane, and here ionic concentration difference is there here. Ionic concentration difference is there. A concentration, ionic concentration gradient. Gradient means here difference. Ionic concentration gradient or difference is maintained across this membrane. Okay, as a result, some secondary form of energy is formed here. Secondary form of energy. So the secondary form of energy, which is not ATP here. What is the primary form of energy? That is always ATP. But here, the secondary form of energy is maintained here, is stored here because of the difference in the ions. Because here, more ions are there. For example, here lesser ions are there. So there is an ionic difference. A gradient is maintained here and the energy is stored because of this gradient. That is what I say here. Secondary form of energy. That is the movement of food particles, which utilizes the secondary form of energy. Such a transport is called as secondary active transport here. But both of them utilizes the energy. That's why it comes under active transport. Clear? Next one is a passive transport, which do not utilize ATP at all or any energy source. Other energy sources also. Or other energy sources. Not only ATP, but also energy sources are not utilized, and there is a movement of particles from the higher to the lower concentration. That is called as a passive transport. The passive transport is of different types. One is the simple diffusion. Simple diffusion. Facilitated diffusion. And osmosis. So passive transport is of three different modes. One is a simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, osmosis. What is simple diffusion and what is facilitated diffusion? Let's discuss now. Simple diffusion. Facilitated diffusion. Here diffusion means, in general, diffusion means the movement of particles from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration. For example, deodorant spray, the gas moves from the region of high concentration where you are spraying to the region of low concentration to the neighboring room. That is a very good example of diffusion. Diffusion of gases from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration here. Here diffusion means not only gases, but also various food particles. Various molecules also diffuse. That is, they remove from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration. Such a process is called as diffusion. Now this diffusion is of two different types. What is that? Simple diffusion and the facilitated diffusion. What is that? Let's discuss now. The simple diffusion, there is a movement of particles. Here also, here higher to the lower concentration. Higher to the lower concentration. Okay, there is no difference here. Here also higher to the lower concentration. There is no difference. But during this process, there is some slight difference is there. You see, when there is a movement of particles, this is a cell, for example, this is a cell, and this is an extracellular space, and this is a plasma membrane, cell membrane, plasma membrane, and this intracellular space, extracellular space. So that there is a movement of particles from the region of here. Concentration here. What is the difference here? Membrane. Here, what is the membrane here? What is the plasma membrane? Okay, simply here they are diffusing here. The region here of the higher to the lower concentration here. Higher to the lower concentration here. Simply they are diffusing, that's it. They are moving as it is. Passively diffusing, that's it. But you take facilitated diffusion here, also higher to the lower concentration, which is a cell, for example, this is the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane. This is a plasma membrane. So this acts as a selectively permeable membrane in the case of the facilitated diffusion. Here also selectively permeable membrane. But what is the difference here? Only the selected particles are allowed from the here, that is this space to the inside. Only the selected particles are allowed here. And that too, even the larger molecules, can be transported here from outside to inside. Larger molecules can be transported. How? Because the cell membrane contains the transmembrane proteins. Membrane proteins are present here. Membrane proteins. Where are these membrane proteins present? The membrane proteins, transmembrane proteins are present on the plasma membrane. What is the function of these membrane proteins? They carry the particles like glucose. They carry the particles like glucose from here, outside the cell, into the cell. For example, glucose molecule is held upon by the membrane protein here. Membrane protein. The membrane protein holds the glucose molecule and takes this glucose molecule from outside the cell into the cell. That's called as a facilitated diffusion. In the facilitated diffusion, example, you take glucose. This is a plasma membrane. The glucose molecule is transported across the plasma membrane into the cell. Here is a cell. Okay. Cytoplasm. The movement of glucose across the plasma membrane into the cell occurs, and that is carried by the special transport membrane here. Transmembrane protein. Transmembrane protein. The transmembrane proteins are present on the plasma membrane. This, it picks up the glucose molecule like this here. This is a transmembrane protein. It picks up the glucose molecule and carries into the cell. So that's why it's called as facilitated diffusion, because it has got, these particles have got the special facility to diffuse from the region of the higher to the lower concentration. But whereas you take the simple diffusion, the glucose cannot be transported here. But the simple diffusion here. This is the plasma membrane again. This is a cell, cytoplasm. And this is outside the cell. The glucose cannot be transported by utilizing the simple diffusion. The glucose can be transported into the cell by only the facilitated diffusion here. That's why in the simple diffusion, only the very smaller molecules can be transported, and when compared to simple diffusion, a little bit larger molecules can also be transported into the cell by utilizing the transmembrane protein facility. That's called as the facilitated diffusion here. So next one is osmosis. The osmosis is confined to the movement of particles, but only the solvents, the liquid substances, are called as the solvents. The solvents are transported by the osmosis. For example, water. Water is transported based on osmotic gradient, which is maintained by osmosis here. Okay, students. From the region of dilute concentration to the higher concentration here. Dilute to the higher concentration, the osmosis gradient is maintained here. Because here dilute, here highly concentrated here, the movement of solvents like water is based on osmosis here. So these are the different particles by which the absorption of the digested food particles occur. Then only the assimilation can fulfill, isn't it? So how these various particles with examples, how the special mechanism, how this is operating, will be discussed in the actual process of absorption in the next lecture. Till then, God bless all of you. Bye, students.